Greetings and thank you for visiting our channel. You're watching Engineering Today, my friend, and as usual, we'll be covering exciting space updates for you today. Starting with the Starship booster and moving on to Russia's threat to the ISS, following the cancellation of ExoMars and NASA's perception that the JWST success has helped the agency win funding. Let's start with Starship. Following a testing explosion on Monday, SpaceX's chief executive, Elon Musk, said that the Starship rocket booster the company intends to use for an initial voyage into space will probably return to its launch mount in Texas the following week. Damage is minimal, but the booster will be moved back to the high bay for checks before likely returning to the launch platform the following week, according to Musk in an email. He said in an email, "Damage is minor, but the booster will be transferred back to the high bay for inspections, returning to the launch stand probably next week." The booster, the tall first half of SpaceX's next-generation Starship rocket system, caught fire on Monday while undergoing pre-launch testing on a stand, sending a shockwave miles across the South Texas complex. Earlier versions of the Starship's top half have been launched by SpaceX a few times in the past, at a height of around 6 miles, or 9.66 kilometers. But the business has never managed to put the roughly 400-foot, or 121.92 meter, tall, fully stacked rocket system into orbit, which is a much more difficult undertaking. The corporation had set a goal of completing the first orbital flight by the end of the summer in order to reach a crucial turning point in the construction of the rocket. But Monday's explosion placed that plan into question. After the explosion, the Federal Aviation Administration, which is in charge of regulating launch and rocket re-entry safety, said it was in close communication with SpaceX, but declined to begin a formal inquiry because the mishap didn't take place during a scheduled launch campaign. Our next update's from Russia. Let's take a look. The use of a European robotic arm on the International Space Station has been threatened by Russia after the European Space Agency formally halted its collaboration with Moscow on the ExoMars mission. The ESA Council formally decided to end cooperation on ExoMars on July 12, according to ESA Director General Joseph Aschbacher. Russia was scheduled to launch a European rover named Rosalind Franklin to the surface of Mars with this mission. Since March, the partnership has not resumed. Although the ESA has only temporarily halted its collaboration with Russia, it seemed improbable that this would ever change. As per Joseph Aschbacher, the decision came because the circumstances which led to the suspension of the cooperation with Roscosmos, the war in Ukraine, and the resulting sanctions continue to prevail. ESA has been considering ways to replace Russia's contributions since it decided to halt its participation on the ExoMars project. The Kazachok landing platform, certain instruments, and radioisotope heating units on the rover were all part of that, in addition to the spacecraft's Proton launch. NASA collaboration and totally European solutions are both possibilities. According to Aschbacher, ESA will offer new insights on the way forward with other partners, with more information to come. ESA, NASA, and the UK Space Agency would convene a briefing on the future of Mars exploration on July 20th in London, according to a media advisory the agency issued on July 13th, outlining its participation at the upcoming Farnborough International Airshow. Despite the fact that the ESA's decision to formally discontinue collaboration with Russia on ExoMars was not unexpected, Roscosmos director Dmitry Rogozin responded angrily to the news. Aschbacher was charged with sabotaging the collaborative ExoMars mission by Rogozin in a post on the social media platform Telegram made shortly after the ESA announcement. The Kazachok platform, which was in Europe getting ready for launch when ESA halted collaboration on the program, would be sought back, he said, adding that Roscosmos would pursue this. Moreover, Rogozin claimed that he had ordered the Russian astronauts to stop using the station's European robotic arm. The Nauka module, which was introduced a year ago and is still being put into service, includes that arm. The execution of the directive and its potential impact on ISS operations were not immediately obvious. Additionally, it wasn't clear if that would cancel Roscosmos cosmonaut Oleg Artemyev and ESA astronaut Samantha Cristoforetti's planned spacewalk from the Russian section of the space station on July 21st. Work on that robotic arm is one of the main goals of that spacewalk. Relationship aboard the ISS between Russia and the Western partners have become more tense, especially after Roscosmos published images on July 4th of Russian cosmonauts holding the flags of two regions of Ukraine that are under Russian occupation. The ESA's Aschbacher agreed with NASA's harsh criticism of Russia for that photo op in a statement released on July 7th. Bill Nelson, the administrator of NASA, spoke to reporters following a ceremony on July 12th at the Goddard Space Flight Center to celebrate the publication of observations from the James Webb Space Telescope. He said, "There is no place on the International Space Station for politics." The ISS crew still maintains a very professional relationship, he emphasized, as do the mission control centers in Houston and Moscow. He also expressed his belief that all partners, including Russia, would continue to be involved through the end of the decade. "This is an international science, technology, and research endeavor that will continue." Nelson said that talks between NASA and Roscosmos regarding a seat barter arrangement to let Russian cosmonauts to fly on commercial crew vehicles in exchange for American astronauts flying on Soyuz spacecraft are still ongoing. Let's take a look at our last update regarding NASA sees JWST success helping win agency support and funding. The James Webb Space Telescope, which was once an albatross around NASA's neck, has now come to represent the agency's capabilities and may even be used as a tool to secure support and money for other projects. That change is now apparent following the $10 billion Space Telescope's successful launch and commissioning, which culminated in the July 12th release of the JWST's maiden observations. A day earlier, the first picture, a deep field view that included galaxies from the early universe, was shown at a White House event. A private briefing with President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris was held after the White House event's brief public component, which lasted around only 10 minutes, finished. After the Goddard event, Nelson expressed his enthusiasm once more to the media. "I received a call from the president asking, 'Hey Bill, do you need any money?' last night. I approached him and said, 'Mr. President, I could need a little assistance with the Office of Management and Budget in your White House,'" he recalled. He recalled that this made the crowd at the White House event chuckle because an OMB official was there. When it came to a proposed budget for NASA's fiscal year 2023, the White House did grant the organization an 8% raise, asking for approximately $26 billion. The increase was scaled back and replaced with $25.4 billion in a bill that the House Appropriations Committee adopted on June 28. The Maryland delegation sent a number of congressmen to the JWST event at Goddard. Senator Chris Van Hollen, Democrat from Maryland, a member of the Senate Appropriations Subcommittee that oversees NASA funding, was one of them. Van Hollen stated in an interview that senators were still working on top-line expenditure amounts for each of the subcommittees. "In the interim, we're going forward in the subcommittees in terms of putting together ideas," he said. "In regards to NASA's budget request, we're going to be pushing very hard to make sure that we completely finance their budget request." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.